Hey everyone, how's it going? Today, we're building a PC. I know, it's weird. I never really shoot videos like this, but then again, I don't really build PCs for a living, so I'm building one today, and I thought I'd film it, because why not, right? Just document it. To run down the specs really quickly, here's an AMD Ryzen 7 3700X. Gone for the Ryzen 7 because this PC is going to be more of a, well, not just a gaming PC, but it's going to be more for workstation and video editing as well. Paired with that, we've got the MSI RTX 2060 Super. Amazing graphics card. It was so tempting to just go for the 2070 Super and then go to 2080, but we stuck to it. We've got this one instead and it's great. We've got 16 gigs of RAM from G.Skill, 3600. For the motherboard, we've gone for the ASUS ROG X570E. I know it's a crazy motherboard, but this is going to quote-unquote future-proof the build, because it's got PCIe 4.0, which we don't really need right now, but if we decide to upgrade to a better graphics card in the future, or even upgrade the CPU, this will allow that. So that's why we're going for this one. It's a bit pricey, but it's also got RGB. Anyway, for storage, we've got an SSD, a Samsung 1TB SSD for the boot, as well as the C drive, obviously, and a Seagate Barracuda 2TB hard drive. And we've got a 550 watt power supply as well from EVGA.
Guys, I'm just jumping in here really quickly whilst editing this video. I'd like to point out that the power supply, so the 550 watt EVGA power supply and the graphics card that I ordered from Scan, ended up being faulty, which was really disappointing because I've never actually had a bad experience with Scan before. So I had to send them back. And whilst getting a replacement for the graphics card, I actually chose to get the Corsair 650 watts power supply instead of the EVGA. I just thought that it might be better to go for a 650 watts instead of a 550 watt in case of upgrades in the future. But yeah, just wanted to point that out. The rest of the video, obviously, I carry on installing the 550 and the graphics card. It all worked in the end. But a few days later, it just stopped working. And that's where the problem started. The PC was already in Becky's house, and I had to FaceTime her on how to, well, install the power supply. So this meant plugging out all of the cables and plugging them back in. But yeah, I hope you guys enjoy the rest of the video, and let's just get right into it.
And that's obviously all going to be sat in this case over here. This is a Corsair. I think it's a 275. Airflow case, I'm not really sure. As you can tell, it's got great airflow in here, hence the name. But yeah, we're going to be putting this together today, and I thought I would just film it. It's not going to be a crazy video. I'm just shooting this with one camera. I could go all out and get someone else and do some cool b-roll, but actually, if you'd like to see that, let me know. If you're interested in seeing me do some crazy builds, I don't know how I'm going to do some crazy builds because I don't have the budget for crazy builds. I put together a build the other day that came to about £6,000 on PC Part Picker. So yeah, maybe not possible. I will be upgrading this in the future. I've got a few things in mind that I'm going to do. So if you'd like to see a cool video with nice B-roll, let me know and I'll shoot that for you. So anyway, I'm going to stop talking now. And well, I might still talk, but I'm going to get into it. Hope you enjoy, and I guess I'll start. I've already opened these before just to check if everything was in here. I didn't want to make this video and kind of open it up and then, you know, find out that I'm missing the CPU and then can't build it. But in this case, we've got CPU obviously and the AMD cooler over here. This is the fan. Reason why I'm just using this for now is because it's cost effective. Actually, something I forgot to mention, this build is under £1,500, and I wanted to stick to that budget, so which is why we're saving up and not really going for an air cooler or a crazy fan. We're just gonna go for the AMD one, which is great. We don't really need one that's you know, an air cooler or anything like that, because I'm not going to be overclocking it just yet. Like I said, I'm going to be shooting another video that I might shoot another video when I'm upgrading the PC and getting things like an air cooler, maybe some RGB fans as well. But who knows? I don't know when that might be. Use the box and then put the motherboard on top of the box just to give you some sort of some height and so it doesn't hit the table. This is the motherboard right here. This looks nice. Oh, now it's shiny. Okay, I'm gonna be careful, but don't really want to touch too many parts. This is what it looks like here. CPU goes in here. Thankfully, we've actually got the fan that comes with the paste already on it, so we're not going to need any thermal for the fan. I'm going to put these cables away for now. I'm not going to need this yet. This is for the RGB and the CPU fan. Sorry, no, the RGB and the USB. So I'll put that aside for now. Here it is, the lovely AMD Ryzen 3700X. And now, when you're handling a CPU, please, please, please don't touch the top. Just try and grab it from the side and then just kind of drop it in as I do. But first you need to find a triangle. Triangle's over here. I don't really know how to show it to you, it's really tiny. But you need to match the triangle to the triangle on the motherboard, which is over there. So I'll do that now. Guys, this is a big moment. It's a big moment. So. There it is. And that is it. It's actually slotted in perfectly. All I need to do now is put down the little thing there. Job done. Easy peasy lemon squeezy. Now we need to put this up. There's a little locking mechanism here, which is really cool. I think that's all it needs, because this case actually comes with it built in. I'm sorry if you can't see this, by the way. In there. That's perfect. So that's sitting right. Can you still see me? So that's now sitting right on top of the CPU cooler. I just need to make sure that this is straight. I think it is there, and now we're just going to do that. There we go. Now the fan needs to be plugged in into the CPU fan mount on the motherboard. Just gonna tidy up the cable, because one thing I hate is bad cable management. Just gonna refer back to the build again, I'm just gonna refer back to the manual again, because I don't really want to make any mistakes and just make sure that I'm on the right track. What I'm looking for at the moment is a diagram of the build of the motherboard. I don't know if you can see this, but that basically tells you where everything is on the motherboard. Next, we're gonna install the RAM. Here is, like I mentioned, the G.Skill Trident Neo Trident Z Neo. Not really sure which way around that goes, but we've got two sticks of 8 gigs. That is 16 gigs in total. A lot better than the graphics. A lot better than the RAM I have in my personal computer. Which, again, if you'd actually like to see a rundown of my computer, let me know and we'll go for that. Another thing that's really important to note is on your motherboard. Check which DIMMs are preferred to be, occupied first. Also make sure you put it the right way around. There's a little notch in the middle here that will tell you if you're putting it the right way or not. Once you plug it in, it's going to give you some feedback. It's going to click it in. And give you that noise. This, I really like the look of this, the stick RAM. It's really cool, not just because of the RGB, but it's just cool. There we go. The RAM is installed. It's just a case. Okay, let's put this away. Also, great tip. Don't be like me and leave stuff on here. When you're done with it, just put it away, because it's not just going to help you tidy up for later, but it's also going to help make sure that you don't put things in the wrong place. Next step, to be honest, is to actually mount this inside the case. So what I'm gonna do now is put this aside. We're gonna start opening up the case, and there's a lot of cables in there that need to be managed before you even start. So the case takes some preparation before you even put the motherboard in there. So this case is has got a tempered glass on this side, which is really cool, but you're gonna need to unscrew these panels. Go. So tempered glass, make sure you store this away nicely. I like to put this in the case that it came in, so I'm gonna go do that really quickly. Now that we've got this open, I'm just gonna open the back as well. To open the back, usually most cases will have it on the back here, so you can, there's two thumb screws, you just pull that out and there you have it. Again, put this somewhere safe. Now, as you can see, the case has got some wires in here, some cables there, and it's also got some cables there. Now, this is probably the most annoying bit for me, because this is where it kind of gets messy. I'm just gonna take this tray out. This tray is a tray for the hard drive, but it also has all of the accessories that I need for the case in there. So I'm going to slip that back in. Usually, a lot of people panic when they open the case and they don't find accessories. This is usually where I'll hide, so make sure you check that out. I think I'm going to just tackle this and talk less, because I just need to get on with it, really. There's a lot of connectors here in the front, so the power, there's the headphone and mic, as well as two USBs and a reset button. That is all this stuff here that needs to be connected to the motherboard, as well as these fans over here that need to be fed through, and these two fans over here that need to be going into the motherboard as well. So all that needs to be tidied up. So one thing to note, your case might actually come with a hub at the back that controls all of the fans. Especially if you have RGB, then you'll have a little hub that sits somewhere in here. This one doesn't. It's got two fans in the front, one fan at the back over there, so that's the cable over there. And obviously this is all of the bottom of the motherboard plugs for the all this stuff over here. And now, good thing about this is that everything is labeled here: CPU 1, VGA 1, VGA 2, perif, stator 1, stator 2, and then this big old 24 pin. Very cool. So CPU, it says right here, there's a little clicky at the bottom. I'll go over there, it'll give you a little sound for satisfaction before the hard drives. So these are SATA cables, and we've then got the data cables in the pack for the motherboard. Well, not for the motherboard, for the hard drives. Good thing about these is that if, for example, I had three hard drives, I could plug all these three in if I was efficient. We only have two, so I'm just gonna use these two over here. Okay, got all of this plugged in here, and now I'm just gonna put this one in. Do I need a... So, okay, cool. Just need to slot this in, basically. And the fan is going to be down because it's got exhaust at the bottom of this case. So, this is a bit tight. There we go. That's a good, this is a good reason why you want to put the cables in first, because then you've really not got loads of room. I don't know if you can see that. Can you see that? Yeah, you haven't got loads of room in here to then plug it in. But anyway, I'm going to screw these in now. The power supply actually came with screwdrivers, so I'm going to use that now. We can really go ahead and start mounting the motherboard inside the CPU. I should have put the motherboard in there before I put the power supply. But it's not a big problem. We're just going to do that now. Cool. Perfect. Now that's in. We'll put our spare screws away because we don't need them at the moment. This is what it looks like. I don't know how much of that you can see. I'm just going to shine it in the light over here. So we've now got the motherboard mounted on the back of this case. So now is the fun part. We connect it all. But first, I'm going to install the SSD and the hard drive. I don't know if I mentioned this, but this is the Samsung 1TB 860 Evo, super light, but this is going to be mounted on one of these. Although there are a few mounts on the back of this to mount the SSD, which is just over here actually. This one here, and I could mount it there, but I'm just wondering. I don't know. It doesn't really heat up in there, so I might do it. I might not. I might change my mind. But I think for now, the best thing would be just to mount it on here and slide it in there. Cool. Once these are done, trays are basically ready to go in. They both have the same mounting, so SATA drives and data drives. So I'm just gonna slot these in really quickly over here. I'm gonna turn this around so you can see. Actually, the most exciting bit is installing the graphics card, which is obviously going to be at the end, because I mean, I don't know who puts a graphics card in first. Not me, definitely. So what I'm going to do now is connect the little guys. What I mean by that is all of these cables over here coming through, all the fans. Once I've connected that, I'm going to start supplying the power to them. Okay, so you'll find something like that. I don't know if you can see it. It basically tells you what goes where. What we need to do now is plug in the graphics card. So let's open the graphics card. The moment everyone's been waiting for. I'm going crazy. It's too late. But wow, this graphics card is a lot bigger than I thought it was. Oh my gosh. Okay, so here is the graphics card. You probably can't see it very well, so I'll just keep it far away. It's really cool. It's got some RGB on here as well, which is just amazing. Remove before gaming. We're just going to take these off at the moment. Now, I just like to make sure that I take the plastic off before I install these, because you can very easily forget these in there and you don't really want any burnt plastics inside your case. Now, you need to check with your motherboard where this actually goes. So this will go in the PCIe 16 at the top. So we've taken these two off, and we need the expansion slots for the graphics card. So make sure you put those back into your motherboard. Graphics card is installed and we put in the screws that we took out. Tighten this up nice and tight. Obviously not too tight so you break the thread. Cable for the graphics card. I'm just going to bring this in. You can see the PC is pretty much done. I've closed the back on there and everything's connected. All I need to do now is actually just power it up, install Windows, and it's good to go. Okay, so now I'm actually installing Windows on it, and I've just booted up the PC, as you can see behind me over there. Everything works smoothly, sounds good, no errors so far. So what I've done is I've loaded, you can see there's a little USB stick sticking up on the PC over there. I've put Windows installer on there, so it's installing Windows. I've also downloaded the latest BIOS update for the motherboard, so I'm going to do that as well. Just the BIOS update for now. I'm going to finish it up. It looks really, really good, especially with the RGB lighting.
Hey guys, I'm jumping in here once again. I hope you guys enjoyed that build. I certainly did. It was a lot of fun building it, although the technical problems that everyone faces whilst building a new computer, having to send back the graphics card and the power supply. In the end, it all works fine. Becky's now got it all set up with a brand new monitor as well. The monitor that she's got is the Aorus 27-inch curved monitor. I'll put it here somewhere on screen so you can see what it looks like. But yeah guys, hope you enjoyed it, and if you did, drop a like, drop a comment down below as well, let me know what you think. And yeah, thanks for watching. See you in the next one.